Hi guys, in this video I'm going to go through a complete setup guide for the Garmin PowerSwitch. Everything covered in this video is listed in the description below, so you just click the time point you're interested in. Obviously this setup will not be, you know, in an actual vehicle, as everyone has different, you know, fit outs and rigs, so it's not going to really help. This guide is just primarily aimed at setting up a spotlight, which is, you know, the most common function for the PowerSwitch, how to wire it, crimp it, and set up to power, and give you an idea of how the app works and the functionality of the PowerSwitch. All right, a quick rundown on the tools needed to wire up the PowerSwitch. First off, you're gonna need a crimping tool. This crimping tool and the wire stripping tool will allow you to strip the wire and put on the correct size eyelet for the PowerSwitch. Garmin supplies 10 that are the correct size, but I'll have a link in the description for if you need an additional, like additional eyelets for some reason. Next up, you need a Phillips head screwdriver. This is for all the screws on the 6 different channels you have on the power switch itself. Finally, you're gonna need a 10mm hex bit, which I've got in this set. Now, this is for the actual power inlet on the power switch. This will be what you run to your battery. Let's get started. In this example here, I'm gonna wire up the spotlight to the power switch itself. First off, you're gonna wanna strip the wire. Just give yourself enough room. Cut, pull, done. Needs to have enough copper that it exposes that the eyelet can make contact with it. Next up, you're gonna wanna crimp directly on. Now, I don't have the right size for my crimping tool, but I'll just have to crush it down. The eyelet now is secured on. I could have, like, obviously you probably want to do a little bit of a better job, but this is just for an example. And I've already stripped it a bit too much on this exact wire. Next up, now to wire in the accessory, you've got a choice of 6 different channels. Now these all need to be plugged into the positive lead, plugged in there, and the negative lead will have to be plugged into like a ground star native distribution block or something like that on your vehicle. Do not plug it into the negative lead on the Garmin PowerSwitch. Now wiring the accessory itself. I'm gonna wire it to channel 4 just because it's easier for me to reach the negative terminal on the battery I've got here. This is a pretty simple step. All you're gonna need to do, undo the screw. Make sure the eyelet's in there. And tighten it in there so that it can't get loose or, you know, escape. Alright, now that we've wired in the power lead for the accessory, we're going to wire in the power lead for the Garmin PowerSwitch. First off, you're going to want to undo the 10mm hex nut on the PowerSwitch. Next up, you're going to want to grab the end that fits into the power switch area. Put that down there. When you're doing this, I would recommend wiring it neatly, not like me. Now, you don't want to over tighten it into oblivion, it just needs to make contact and not be able to get loose. So, I might tip the power switch, which is why the power switch comes with the screws to allow you to tighten it to a surface. Alright, now that we've got the positive lead plugged in, we're going to do the negative lead. Now, this one, again, 2 different size ends. Obviously, the end that fits is the end you're going to use on the power switch itself. The other end will go to the negative on your battery. In your vehicle. to pair the Garmin PowerSwitch with your PowerSwitch app on your smartphone. First off, once you've installed the PowerSwitch app on your smartphone, you'll need to click Pair PowerSwitch. As soon as it's done that, it'll ask you to put the PowerSwitch into pairing mode, which is done by just holding the Pair button until it blinks blue. Once done that, click on Pair, it'll come up on your screen. Wait for it to connect. That's it. Now you're connected. This will allow you to control any function on the app. So as you can see here, by tapping on or off, I can turn on the connected accessory, which in this case is the spotlight. Now that you've paired up your Garmin PowerSwitch, what we're going to do now is we're going to have a look at editing it and what you have available to you within the PowerSwitch app itself. So first off, click editing on the top bar, then click the pencil icon. I'm going to label this spotlight. Obviously you can label it whatever it's the accessories wired into the channel relating to it. Pick your icons. This is obviously a light icon, but what you get in this app menu is it gives you a lot of ideas of what this, you know, what you can use the PowerSwitch for. So you can use it to, like, you know, wire even fridge accessories, fans, seat warmers, other, like, you know, your Bluetooth speaker. You can really go pretty far with this and make your campsite pretty smart, even not just your vehicle. So it's a lot to play with if you want to go down that route. In this example, we're just going to go specifically through the spotlight. So once you've labeled it and got your button, you know how you want it looking, then you can choose the button mode. So you've got normal, momentary, which momentary works just as long as you hold the button on. That's how long it's on. Next up, you've got strobe. Now strobe, you can play with the timing of the intervals, so you can get it to strobe faster, or stay on longer, or stay off longer. So that allows you to just speed that up. So it's strobing quite fast now. But obviously you have full custom control over this. You can also play with the dim settings on this. For an old globe like this, it's a bit harder, doesn't work as well, but for more modern lights, you'll actually see a lot more control by dimming it. Now, if you're looking for more information about what the PowerSwitch can do, we've got a blog article up, which is sort of a written format of this video, but it'll also give you some more ideas or some more examples of what's possible with the PowerSwitch. If you have any questions, leave comments down below. Thanks for watching.